Welcome back. We recently talked about preventing mosquito bites, and now Dr. Apple Bodemer with UW Health is here to talk about diseases transmitted by mosquitoes. Of course, we've been hearing a lot about the Zika virus. So what can you tell us about that? What's the latest?
Well, the Zika virus is transmitted by a mosquito called the Aedes mosquito. And at this point, we have not seen that type of mosquito here in Wisconsin. All the cases of Zika that have occurred in Wisconsin have been associated with travel to infested areas, and those include Africa, Southeast Asia, the Pacific Islands, South America, the Caribbean, the Virgin Islands. Puerto Rico is a real hot spot right now, and I just recently heard that there have been a few cases in Florida that they believe are related to just mosquitoes in Florida having the virus.
And so if people are traveling to any of these areas, how do they know if they get Zika? I've heard that you can have flu symptoms, but you might not.
Yeah, almost 80% of people that have the virus are estimated not to have symptoms. Okay. So in that case, if you've been to an infested area, if you're not pregnant, it's not that big of a deal. But if you are pregnant, you might want to get tested, and it's a blood test or urine test that you can ask your doctor about. For the people that do have symptoms, they usually are very mild. They last about 2 to 7 days and go away on their own. They include fever, itchy skin rash, achy joints, especially of the hands and feet, and then you can get redness or irritation of the eyes.
And if you're not pregnant and there's not that huge concern, you should still notify your doctor, let somebody know that you're experiencing those symptoms.
It's good to identify that, and then mainly because we want to try to minimize you getting bitten by a mosquito so that you don't transmit it. Mm-hmm. And I want to say the big problem with this virus right now is that it can cause birth defects, including incomplete brain development. So if you are pregnant and are in an area where we know Zika exists, it's really important to take any precautions you can to avoid mosquito bites.
What other things can mosquitoes carry?
Well, there are a host of diseases, and actually mosquitoes are probably the most important insect when it comes to transmitting human illnesses. Mm-hmm. They tend to be very regional. So in Wisconsin, we've identified West Nile virus and a couple of the encephalitis viruses. For more specific information, you can go to the CDC website or the Wisconsin Department of Health Services website.
What's the best way to prevent getting a bite? If you look at that list and go, ugh.
Yeah. Yeah, so mosquitoes love water. They breed and live near it. So minimizing your exposure, wetlands or standing water, is very important. Covering up as much skin as you can with loose-fitting, lightly colored clothing, making sure the screens on your home and tent are intact, and then, of course, mosquito repellents, using those appropriately.
And what do you have here?
So here I have, permethrin is a great one. It cannot be applied directly to the skin.
Oh.
So this actually, you would spray onto clothing or tents, other gear, and let it dry, and then it lasts for several weeks or even through washings.
Oh,
so that's a great one. In terms of the other repellents that can be applied to the skin, Consumer Reports has tested them specifically against the Aedes mosquito and found that the most effective ones last about 7 to 8 hours and contain either 20% picaridin, 25 to 30% DEET, or 30% oil of lemon eucalyptus.
So you've got to read the label, and you've got to look for those percentages, because not all brands have that amount.
Right. And the other thing, too, is they did test several of the essential oil blends. So the more natural ones really are only effective for up to an hour. So if you're going to go that route, you want to be applying very, very frequently.
I know we're out of time. Anything we need to know about with kids?
Yeah. First of all, don't put it near their eyes, nose, mouth. Don't put it on their hands, because we all know that their hands go right into their mouth or nose. So an adult should be applying it sparingly and then wash it off of their skin when they come indoors.
Good advice, especially with all the water we had last night.
Yes.
There's a lot out there today. And we're going to turn it over to AJ for the latest on that.